Before the video, our tip of the day brought to you by Spicy. Here's a tip on mechanics in Project Zomboid. Survival tip number 4. Mechanic skill lets you hotwire cars. Train it by stripping cars you aren't using for parts. Accelerate the process by reading mechanics skill books. Now back to our video presentation. Hey guys, welcome back for some more Project Zomboid. Here's a little recap of everything that's happened since I last saved. Hey everybody, future ambiguous amphibian here. First, I spent about 4 days reading books, so I'm about 200 IQ smarter now. And I got very hungry, and I also spent a lot of time cleaning the floors. I cleaned the blood all off of the inside of the garage, so now that's spotless. And then I cleaned the outside, because it was disgusting also. After that, I decided to go break into a few of the houses nearby, and I found a big hiking bag, and I even found a sledgehammer, so it kind of affects everything that we're gonna do today. So I was thinking that since we had such good luck, we may as well make a road trip over to West Point, now while the getting is still good, and go to the gun store, see if we can take down the wall, and then hopefully get everything inside. While we're in West Point, it's a lot more industrial over there, and not really into urban over there. We could probably make a stop at the grocery store, throw all of that in our car, and then bring back a lot of food and firearms that we need, because I did spend a long time reading over the last few days, and even though that our skills are now primed and ready to, improve, we're getting really low on food with all that supply that we got from the other day. So I've had a lot of really good stuff. The big hiking bag and the sledgehammers really made it for me. And I can't believe that so much of the stuff I was looking for was right next to my base when I was spending all that time looking in the most commonly searched locations. I also took down the staircase to my upstairs, so now I'm pretty much completely safe when I'm sleeping. Of course, they could come here while I'm asleep, but it seems like that this base area is pretty much quiet for right now. That's all about to change, though, when I make this trip. I don't know if this is going to be bad. It'll probably be fine. I just think it's going to be hard when we get to the gun store to try to get it back in one piece. Though I still have seen a few around here, and really, as the months go by, I think that the biggest enemy is going to be the elements. It's going to start to get cold, and I still have only one jacket. I don't really have any renewable source of heat. We're still only at August 6th, but I mean, you know, the winter's gonna start to hit really, really fast. Okay, so anyway, let's try to see how long we can keep this car alive for, and just go right over to West Point. So I found a key on the side of the road. I think this is probably worth examining. Franklin Value Line. I believe that's these vans. And if I could find a van that's in better condition than my car... Is that to this? I do have a can of gas on me. Holy crap! This is gonna be way better than our, like, station wagon that we've been driving around. I'm gonna take everything out of the station wagon and just abandon that right here. Let me just do a really quick check on the other car to make sure that there's nothing completely wrong with it. But I was really hoping to find a higher capacity vehicle, and I think that this thing's... I mean, you still gotta consider the trunk, but... Like, you don't have all the seat storage space, but... Let me just count it out. You got 20 in one seat, plus 8 for the, glove box. So that makes 28. And then in the trunk... You got 66 storage space. I think that that can also go down if you damage the trunk, whereas the seat storage space does not... I mean, correct me if I'm wrong. I might be totally wrong about that, but I think that seat storage space never goes down, no matter how damaged the car... Well, then I just will try not to damage the car. Plus, this car is also in better condition, and I've also kind of treated the other one like crap. All right, so that's 66 plus 28, and this one's got... how much does it have in the trunk? 51 in the trunk. That's actually a pretty good sell. And then, how much does that have in each? I'll be damned. This car has 60 plus 50. So actually, this one has more storage space. I would never guess that, looking at this car. In that case, you know what? Screw it. Let's just stay with our old one. Eventually, there may be a chance to come back here to get both cars. I doubt it, because when you're on single player, it's not really an option to get multiple cars unless if you get really lucky in your own town. But if my car breaks down on the way, I'll have something to come back to. Because we made it just short of the gun store right now. I want to stop at the Gigamart, because this is usually the best place for food. And I was thinking of coming here, but it looks like that the entire town is pretty much mobbed. So I don't think this type of entrance to the Gigamart would be beneficial for our cause, if that makes sense. I think I'm going to just go straight to the gun store at this point. Anyone standing in my way? No. Wow, it's pretty secluded. Okay, you know, like, not bad. Alright, let's actually get to creeping now, because my goal is not to make a ruckus while I'm here. I just want to get the stuff and get out. I just want to get all of it and then leave. Food will be more complicated, because food is pretty heavy, but are you kidding me? Ooh, I was hoping that this wouldn't happen right now. Right, I guess we're gonna have to fight two. Now, there are ways to, like, shyster it so that you can have a car parked in front of the gun shop while you're in there. Wow, we are getting way better with the axe now. This has got to be the way to do it. It used to be that it was stupid to use your weapon on the ground because it wasted weapon condition. I think that might be true, but I'm not so worried about weapon condition when they're going to kill me, if that makes sense. Man, I'm wondering if I'm going to need to use the weapons in the gun store to help myself get into the gun store, but that doesn't make any sense. That's like getting a chicken before an egg. It had to be the egg first. Alright, this is getting to be too much. Too much! Now, the problem is this. If the door were open right now, then I could open the door and I could park the car next to it, and then I could just get out of the car and have that be the only entrance into the gun store. That's what I'm thinking it's ultimately going to come down to. But I seem to be attracting a lot more. Let me just get out of here for a second. We'll just move all the way out. We'll gather them all up. And I am getting very panicked. That's never a good thing. But I'm not going to try to aim at them anymore. I'm going to try to aim only at the door. Will those idiots please follow me? There's like 20 other people here. It's like an all-you-can-eat buffet for me. Great. Okay, I'm going to attract these ones away and then kind of like creep back over while it's quieter, because that was way more than I started with here. Oh my god, that's a motorcycle helmet. I haven't even seen that yet. That's so cool. Alright, let's take all these ones away. We'll head back. We'll try to creep back over there. And then we'll destroy the door and park the car in front of the door. Not what I envisioned I would be doing today, but it works. At this point, I think I'm just gonna clear out everything. Alright. Ironically, a bunch of them... Who is moaning over there? It sounds like one of them's underneath a car, I think. Alright, we got a couple more. Let's just take out these. I keep hearing somebody behind me, and it's making me mad nervous. Alright, we finally got, I think that's every last zombie that was in front of this place. I tried desperately to parallel park in front of the door, but for some reason my car kept, like, letting each side... it didn't work. But death worked, so... I mean, that's always another option. Yeah, I ran over. I don't know if it even gets added to my kill count. I don't believe that it does. But at this point, I'm sick of murder. And I want to... Well, it's not murder. It's self-defense in this case. To justify my actions to you, disembodied viewer. Let's see. Hungry, tired, moderate exertion doesn't really matter because we found all of the best stuff. There's shooting glasses. I didn't even know that these were in the game. Oh, shit. Damn, I look like a bug in these. That is good. Alright, well, we found a shotgun. I'm gonna be able to confirm and deny a lot of the rumors about shotguns. Revolvers. There's a lot of... This is basically ORGM, but in the main game. A 2x scope. I believe that was in the main to begin with. We got that. Good. Whatever all of this is, we just got revolvers. A sling, more revolvers. Revolvers are okay. I was hoping I'd find a lot of magazines for guns, because we do have two weapons that have magazines back home. Let's see, more 9mm Magnum, 38. Yeah, we got a lot of, I mean, this is not bad. And they have a lot of skill books in here, too. I wasn't really planning on even getting those. But this is still not a bad thing by any stretch of the imagination. Okay, let's just see if we can open up the rest of the car. This is a lot of ammo. I really was hoping for ammo, and this is great because I think the gun store didn't used to be supplied with this much ammo. I don't know if the spawns changed or what, but usually the main thing is that you can find a lot of guns, but you can't find a lot of ammo, and you just need the ammo to train. There's not that many shotgun, or did I even find any shotgun shells? There is also some zombie that I think is just, like, stuck underneath a car over there and I can't find. Nor do I really want to locate it, because I know that if I find it, it's going to kill me. Ammo straps. That can't be bad. Okay, good. Wow, two boxes. It's like four more boxes of ammo. I don't think that they come in quite as great a variety as the ORGM, though, ammo. Okay, hunting knife is not bad. Actually, I don't believe I've even found a hunting knife at all in this run. That'll be really good. A fiberglass stock. I'm trying to think of what I would need that for. Can it be mounted on an MSR-788 rifle, MSR-700 rifle, weapon attachment. Decreases firearm weight and increases accuracy. And what do these do? Oh, wow. I hope that we find a rifle. I mean, it's probably going to be a while until we can actually use one. And I'm not even sure that rifles are going to be all that useful. Only because they're going to make a lot of noise. Unless we can find beginner mechanics, I'm probably not going to take any of these books. Only because I'm planning on doing a bookstore run and I'd like to conserve as much space as possible for food. Thank you for not having any zombies in here. I found it! What type of weapon is this? A rifle is what it is. Does that even take a... I don't even think it takes a magazine. Yeah, it probably doesn't even have a magazine in it. It does need a magazine. And I don't believe that we have any magazines. That is a problem. Okay, we'll need to find magazines for that. Hopefully there are some back here. I don't need these walkie-talkies, but I will leave them here, actually. Because I do have a ham radio. U.S. Army... Is that different from the one I have? I don't care. There's no one left in the universe except for me, for all intents and purposes. You know, that's the most depressing thought whenever I play this. Okay. Wow, I did not expect to find shooting glasses. That's kind of cool. And there's a bunch of money back here, too. I found a bunch of money lying around on the ground in one house. It looked like people had been gambling there. Wow, at this point, that is amazing. I never expected that we would find this much ammo. I thought we would find a greater variety of guns. So I don't know if those will be added in ORGM or anything like that, but there are also weapons that I did not find here that I have found in the rest of the game world, so who knows, there are probably other guns out there just waiting to be discovered by us. Wow, that's pretty much it. I'm done with the series now. I can call it quits. I did everything I wanted to once I got into the gun store. Fortunately, I also found beta blockers out here. But I do think that there are zombies out here that actually had weapons on them because, well, I saw one, so I know it for a fact. I don't believe it. We're gonna have enough ammo to last us, like, through the winter. I mean, if there were hunting in the game, I'd have more than a... Ooh, I forgot that hunting is gonna... I think that's gonna be the next update to the game. That's gonna be crazy cool, don't you think? Yeah, it is. Let's get jacket. Let's get... God, it's really frustrating to search through a million corpses for one thing that you thought was there. Alright, I'll be back in a second. Ah, I found it! Okay, there's another M1911 in here. We already have an M1911, but maybe that's the extent of the guns. I don't know. I can't confirm that for a fact at all. But we did find a lot of painkillers and other good meds out here, too. So this is by no means been good. Ooh, hi. Sledgehammer takes way too long for me to wind up. I should probably just run. Actually, why not give it a try? Ranger jacket, too. Oh, that could probably be good in the winter. I should probably start gathering up some of these other bits of clothing. Okay, now we do have the key to that car, but I think I'm just going to stick with this one for the sake of simplicity. At this point, I'll grab a couple more clothing items I see on them out here, and then I think it's off to the grocery store, and then probably back home, because I am getting homesick. We actually have a really nice house. I've never had a house this nice in a series. And now we have everything that we need to defend it, so why not go back? Alright, now before we leave, I need to get a lot of alcohol at Twiggy's so that I can have an alcohol party when I get back. We're going to take all of the motorcycle helmets that we found because they're awesome, and why not? And let's get the jackets too, because, I mean, when you can be in style, why not? Let's see. I actually want to try one of these things. Now, I don't know if this will actually defend my head when I'm driving, but I imagine it'll pretty much be good all the time. Let's get all of the rest of this stuff in here, and then... Oh, I just put it on the ground accidentally. Never mind. Oh, I forgot that I had no room in the trunk. Okay, let's get everything back out, and then we'll get all of the whiskey from Twiggy's, and then we'll get all of the food from the grocery store, and then we'll go home and we'll have a massive party alone. Holy shit, I never thought I would find one of those, like, Vietnam vet motors. And a holy fucking ball sack! That's not what I think it is! That's not a USA Rock t-shirt and aviator glasses with a crash helmet. Let's just take all of this man's clothes. This is clearly the coolest man to ever become a zombie. Okay. Alright, it's time to have an alcohol party at home, alone. A loneliness party. Okay, it may have cost me 2 days worth of sleep, all of my exhaustion, and it may have destroyed about half of the front of the shirt, but I did manage to find an American flag shirt. I don't know what you call it, a crash helmet. I didn't know what you called those things. And aviator sunglasses, which are gonna be completely worth it. At this point, I'm too nervous to sleep anywhere around here, only because it's completely wide open. So I think we're just gonna go back home. We didn't find food, really, but we found a lot of alcohol, which we'll substitute for a good enough time. And food is everywhere. We probably won't find quite as much- yeah, look at the grocery store, I don't want to go in there. At this point, let's just go home, and then relax. Okay, and we are just about home sweet home now. I've been pretty relentless in running over zombies on the way there and back because I don't think I'm gonna get much use out of this car after this. Oh, that was a nice duffel bag on that suited zombie, but we'll leave that for another time. We already have duffels now, and we do have a big hiking bag, so we're good. I'm probably gonna have to trade this car in for another one at rent-a-car at some point. But let's just see how much damage was done to this. Well, first I need to you know what, I'll check the car and then I'll sleep. Fortunately, you can't fall asleep on the ground yet, like in The Sims, but you can be pretty much rendered useless with that. Wow, 72.1% condition, eh? Surprisingly, the driver's seat is one of the worst harmed things. I guess my ass must just be like that, like, you know how they say you have the mud butt when you're, when you've just been sweating a lot in your pants? Well, I have, like, the bloody, like, just dead guy mud butt right now. I think I'm gonna go to sleep. We'll wake up in the morning, we'll eat something, and then after that we'll sort out all the ammo. And, I mean, as for me, I hope I didn't forget to do anything really important. I always think that whenever I go to sleep in this game, I'm like, that was kind of a rash decision. But my policy is that the ammo is useless if we can't aim with it, so we gotta bring up the skill. And we're getting close to the next axe level too, though. I mean, that is quite nice, but guns offer the possibility that we might not even need to get near zombies to fight them. Though I still do like the melee now, and I think I've gotten better at it. Let's climb through, and we'll just sort out all the guns. Okay, this is turning into a Gnomus level good Project Zomboid playthrough, and I believe Gnomus has actually started his own series, which I was very pleased by. I started watching it. He is a great Project Zomboid player, and I get a lot of my ideas from watching him. But let's just go through what we have as we drink an entire bottle of red wine. I don't believe that will kill me. Let's just see. Actually, let me get rid of this heavy load. Sledgehammer. Yeah, I mean, I'm surprised that there's no animation for insane projectile vomiting with the amount that my character drinks. Fairly heavy load. Minor injuries. Yeah, we'll be alright. We'll be okay. We've made it 29 days night. Hey, almost 30 days now. And 225 zombies killed. But we have all of this ammo and gun power. Holy crap. We have enough to reenact the Civil War here. I think at this point, I'm just going to spend the rest of the day just shooting them in the face. I can't think of anything better to do. I got all my skills, and then we'll probably pursue getting, because, well, you know we're going to go through all that ammo because our accuracy is so laughably bad that it's going to take that long to get better. I have no idea if the shooting glasses have any effect on it, but we'll find out, won't we? Okay, so in the last video, I spent some time explaining some of the shooting and how it's related to ORGM. Now, a lot of you guys are better than me at this, but for those of you who don't know, when you reload shotguns, you don't have magazines at all anymore. You just have shells that you reload directly into the gun. So there really isn't any forward preparation. You could bring multiple shotguns, but then you're carrying around more. And a tip given to me by Max Stone for this day was that you should use a shotgun because every single hit on zombies counts toward your accuracy rating. You can also use them in kind of panic situations, close range, so it makes sense to use shotguns for a low-level shooter. So what I think I'm going to try to do now is just gather up a horde that's decently large. I should have brought beta blockers with me. Actually, let me just go back and grab them. And then we're going to try to keep the panic low and just get as many hits on the horde as we can to get to gain on that shooting stat. Once we do that, eventually we'll move into like rifle marksmanship, but it's definitely not something that we want to start off with for our characters. So let's just head back, because we did, unfortunately they weren't like in the gun store. You'd think that they'd be selling some beta blockers. I don't know. But we did manage to find 6 bottles of them elsewhere, so I'll grab, you know, I don't want to take too many of anything, because otherwise my heart might stop. So I think I'm going to, let's just take one. Anyway, let's go find a horde of zombies. Okay, we managed to gather up a decently big enough group. Now, remember, I'm not doing this actually to clear out the area. I'm just doing this for the gun skill, because we want to be able to actually use guns as part of our arsenal, which we've not really done before. Okay, I probably got a hit on about 4 there. I wasn't really counting, but I did it twice, and now we're at, 17.25. That's really, really fast. Thanks again, Max, for this tip, because that just saved us a lot of time. Okay, and let's see. And we're probably going to want to keep moving. As we move, we're going to reload. Actually, I shouldn't even really be jogging like this, because, well, walking is enough. It's always been enough. All right, let's get a few more. 3, 4. Just make sure there's none behind me. Now, another possible technique here is going to be to have a fence behind you that you can, that you can hop over. Clearly, I was not thinking when I chose this area. Okay, let's just see how many more we can gather up in a group. I wonder what my kill count is at now. 249. Well, this is could be a really fast way to get a lot of kills. If that's what you're in it for, this beta test. Okay. Just keep on reloading. My goal is to get, like, the first level of aim by the time this is done. Doesn't really even make a difference. Wow, we could probably get to level 2 with aim by the time this is done. Come to think of it. Doesn't really make a big difference with shotguns. I don't know, maybe it leads to more headshots? Like, some of them are just knocking over that I'm shooting, but... Make sure to keep an eye behind me. Just gonna shoot that guy. Three, that's pretty good. And we are tapped out. Okay, let's get more. I still have a lot of boxes of shotgun shells back home, so I'm not too worried about losing anything. Holy crap, I didn't expect to be this bloody by the time it was over. Well, it's not over yet. One thing to note is you can only, like, walk while you're reloading. But do walk while you're reloading, because if you aren't, then it's a total waste. There we go. And you're probably just gonna have... Like, this is the reason why guns... don't make such great... I mean, like, they're good for taking out a lot, but they just draw twice as many to the location. There's really no point most of the time. I expect in a few weeks, though, that by the time that this area is largely cleared out, I mean, unless if they've completely started respawning in the area, it might be worth it by that point to use, like, a marksman rifle or something. Or by the time that I'm so good with pistols and reloading... that it's just not even a second thought. Not too many behind. Holy crap, that is nice. It is way more satisfying. I have never had this. Or I haven't had this experience yet where there's so many. I'm trying to compare and contrast with the feeling of having an M2. What was it? I can't remember what the name of the model, the machine gun. In RDM. I think it's like an M. 249 or something like that. That is probably the most messed up weapon in the game, though. The thing cannot be stopped. And I am... Why am I leading them back to my house? I have to get out of here. I'm going to lead them to a fence, and I'm going to jump over the fence, hopefully when I'm being out of ammo. We got three there. There's one behind me. Make sure you keep checking your side. That's always been the battle in this game. Okay, we're going to move in here. We're going to load in those last four shells. And then we're going to hop that fence over there, and then we're going to go back to our home. Having just led a lot more to our home. I really hope there's not a bunch in here. And it sounds like that's out. Wait, we still got four left. Is it jammed? Wait, no. I don't even know if they can jam. Okay, there we go. Oh, shit, I hope that there's not any in those rustling bushes over there. Alright, it looks like we're safe! And let's just do this. Ooh, I... Oh, that guy might have been too... Hey, hands up! And it seems I am trapped in this animation. Ah, never mind, I am not anymore. Three, and... I probably could have done better. Shell for shell, but let's just hop the fence now and get out of here. And we are safe. Okay. I mean, you know, safe in quotes. But, you know, hopping multiple fences or one fence is probably going to be a good way from now on to get some distance between you and them. Gosh, it makes me think if I'll ever spend time, you know, like going from roof to roof. That would be a really cool way to traverse the world. If you found some way... Or, like, if there was a stat for your character that you could jump on roofs, or, like, climb up roofs, you know, like, hardcore parkour and such. and then you could just jump from roof to roof surviving. You know, I've always had that thought when I thought of what I would do in a real-life zombie apocalypse. All right, so how far did we get? I'd say we've done all of our work for today. For some reason, I'm not... leveling up my reloading. I don't know if that's because of the test build or what, but our aiming is at 37.5 or 37.25 out of 150. Alright, I did not expect to get this covered up in blood, so next time we'll have to make another run to the homes. This is so bad. Anyway, we've still got so much more ammo, so let me know what you guys want to see. If you have any questions about the guns, anything that you Haven't been able to try it. And as always, I will see you guys in the next video. Bye-bye.